Welcome back. I decided to buy one of these linear axes from eBay. This is a 40 centimeter axis with a bevel screw and linear bearing. So very robust. All I did was add these two limit switches and design the mounting brackets that go into this slot here. So the axis comes with this T-slot nuts. So I just bolted these, designed these in AutoCAD, and bolted these both upper treble limit switches and added a inductive proximity switch to the axis. So the axis can be homed. And sorry, both of them are wire. And the prox switch to the inputs on the PLC. The high speed pulsing outputs going to the stepper driver here, which I also bought from eBay. This can take up to 24 volts on their inputs. That's what it says here, 5 to 24 volts. The axis is powered by a 24 volt power supply. And I decided to condense all the functions into a single instantiated function block. So I can reuse this for multiple axes, up to four, according to the documentation from Siemens. You can have up to four axes and they can move simultaneously. So this is a single axis, but you can have a Cartesian system. So right now, this function block condenses all these functions. So if I were to collapse it, I have power up drive, which is this function, this instruction here, and the homing with the over treble, I mean the over treble, not the over treble, the timeout timer set to 30 seconds here. Is the home time max 30 seconds. So if you're on a reach home in 30 seconds, there's something wrong. Like if you unplug the power supply and you're on a home in 30 seconds, you get this fault. So which is something I'm actually gonna do in a minute. And you got to check if command position is within limits. So I have defined the limits to be -20 to 360. Millimeters for the axis. So those get checked in by that block, and if the limits are okay, it will allow the axis to move. And there's of course more statuses: reset, enable, disable the drive, and axis home status, amp position status, moving axis status, and current position value. And one thing I wanted to mention here is that I added this global DB and made it unoptimized so I can see the offset. The reason for that is because I wrote a C-sharp runtime HMI on C-sharp using Snap 7. So it's already compiled and it's running right here. So that's the HMI, the runtime. So it uses this DB with its offset to set this booleans here, all these booleans, these buttons, these statuses, and the values are all in this DB here. So let me enable the drive. So the drive needs to be enabled and then home it. So homing is a low rate and I'm trying to get a nicer image of it. Let me just swing this to the side so you actually witness the homing. So I got home. Now, The status is access home, turn on. I'm going to here, move to the plus limit here, which is 360. So let me, let's try that first. It goes in a ramp and then decelerates. So that's acceleration, max speed, and deceleration. So it's like 5 seconds and so. So that's why it decelerated to reach the end position. So I want to move to 180. You may not reach 150 because of the travel distance, but that's halfway in between. I'm right there. So I want to try and do the home access fault here. So I'm going to stop the PLC, instead of powering off and on, I'm going to stop the PLC and then turn it back to run. And once it goes back to run, you'll see that the drive is disabled because it just, the PLC just restarted. So if I were to unplug the power supply for the drive, so there's no power for the motor anymore, you can enable it. And the axis supposedly is moving, but it's not. It's going to time out here. Here it's going to time out. Let me see. Yeah, you should get the axis fault in 30 seconds. Let's see. I don't think I'm online here. No, it's actually axis. There. So the axis faulted. So what needs to happen is you need to reset the home fault, disable the drive. And then I'm gonna power it back on. Enable the drive. And it's gonna home itself. And once it homes, you see the value, which is arbitrary, turn to zero. And we're back in business. So you can now jog the axis to whatever position you want. You can actually convert this into an array of a speed and value and make the axis run a program of steps. Say you have different products, so you have the axis move to different locations depending on an array, so you can play, and it will go to a series of steps. And you can actually add another axis to it and have an XY or XZ depending. So this shows that you can do motion control at a budget with this. Of course, there's no feedback other than the limit switches and the home switch. But for smaller projects that you're going to do some motion control without putting a lot of money into it, this is around $80 and this is around $26. All you need is a normal 24-volt power supply. And there you have it. Low-end Siemens PLC can do up to four accesses. So that's it. Thank you for watching.